So yesterday we have seen this HTML example in that we use a root tag, then we give title to our web page, then we create heading of that paragraph, and then we create different paragraphs in our web page. So yesterday we have seen full form of HTML. So HTML full form is hypertext markup language. In that there are different tags we can use that. We have seen that first example and its explanation. So these are the tags we have seen yesterday. How we can display output of HTML web page in browser, what is the structure of HTML, then HTML history that we have seen, recent HTML version HTML 5.2, then we have seen how to type HTML code in Notepad, then how to save that. So you can open Notepad by following these steps: start, programs, accessories, Notepad. Then you type this code. So in that HTML code is there with different tags in Notepad. Then you can save that HTML page using file save as, and then you can give name and extension is .htm. So you have to set encoding as UTF-8. So in this way you can create your first HTML web page using Notepad in Windows. Then to display that HTML page, you can right click on that and you can open with the browser installed in your system. So then you will get this output. So W3 School website provides online editor. In that online editor, you can click on try it yourself and you can view your code in the left side and you can view the output in the right side. Yesterday I have So there are different tags. Yesterday we have seen how to give headings to different paragraphs in HTML. So H1 to H6 tags are used to give the heading to your web page. So H1 is the most important heading, H1, H6 is the least important heading. For that you can use. Then for paragraphs, P tag. In P tag you write whole paragraph text and then you can close that. So you can see here, this is the first paragraph. In P tag that text is written, then second paragraph in that text is written, and this is the second paragraph. Yesterday we have seen this output by clicking on try it yourself. You can visit this website and do hands-on practice. You can create your different paragraphs in HTML. You can create different links. So yesterday I have shown how you can create your own links using anchor tag. A tag is anchor tag. So in that href attribute, so href is the property of anchor tag. In that you give the website address which you want to open, and here you are writing that text, which text you have to give for that link. And when you click on this text, then this website will be open in your web page. Your web page will be redirected to that website. Also yesterday we have seen how you can add images in your web page. So to add images, you have to use img tag. So img tag has different attributes, like src. In that you give the path of the image. Then alt means if that image is not present, then alternative text will be displayed. Then what is the width and height you have to set for that image, that you can give in pixel. So you can see here in example. So this is the width of that image and this is the height of that image in pixels. So like that you can create your web pages. Then if you open any web page and you want to see the source code, then you can right click on that web page and then click on view page source, or in Microsoft Edge you can click on view source. So you can see that whole HTML code of that web page. Then if you want to see particular element, then you can select inspect an HTML element. So you can see that code, how button is created in HTML, how text box is created in HTML. So for that you have to select inspect or inspect element option in your browser. So in that you can see HTML code as well as CSS, cascading style sheet, how look and feel is given to that HTML page. So in this way you can see that source code of any HTML page. If you open facebook.com, you can right click and you can see that whole HTML source code of Facebook. Getting all of you? Next, HTML having different elements. So each element having starting tag and ending tag. In between you write text, some content, whatever you want to display in your web page. So that we have seen every tag has tag name and we have to close that using slash tag name, and whatever text you have to write, you write in between that tags, opening and closing. So like that here for h1 we have written this my first heading, so that will be displayed as a heading name. Then in paragraph fill tag we use my first paragraph, so that will be displayed in the paragraph. Then br tag for giving space in your paragraph, that some content you want to display on the next line, you use br tag, line break tag. And this is the empty tag. In HTML there are two types of tags are there. Here h1 tag is having opening and closing, p tag is having opening and closing, but br tag is empty tag. It is having only start tag, opening only, no closing. Then in HTML you can use nested HTML elements. So what is nested HTML element? Means elements inside the element. So you can see here in HTML tag we have nested body tag. So inside HTML we have used body tag. In the body tag we have used h1 tag and p tag. So like that, this is the nesting. Element inside the element, tag inside the tag. So this is called as nesting. And when you use nesting of tags, Prajakta Ganle, when you use nesting of tag, whatever the tag you have opened first, that will be close at the last. So HTML is started at the first, so it is close at the last. So this is the root tag. Then body is open here, body is closed at the second last after HTML. So like that, you have to maintain the hierarchy. So this is called as nesting of tags. Getting all of you? So here one example is given. So in that we have skipped the end tag. End tag is not displayed. So you can see here paragraphs, two paragraphs are there, and in that closing is not there. This is a paragraph, this is a paragraph. Then we can see the output. What will be the output? Can anyone tell? If you forget to close that tag, what problem may occur? Any problem occur or you will get that same output? See this. So now I type that closing of tag slash p. Suppose I forget to close HTML tag, then what will happen? So when you do any changes, then you have to click on that run. So here we are getting output, but every tag, that pair tag, you have to compulsory close. See that. Suppose I miss the opening of that paragraph. So it takes some time for displaying. So now you can see. Yes. So this is the first paragraph. And this is the second paragraph. Then in paragraph you want to give space, then you use br tag. So let's see the output. So see here, in between that paragraph br tag is used so that text is displayed on the second line. If I use br tag here again, line break, then that next line will be displayed on the next line. So this is the use of br tag. That line will be displayed on the next line. If you give spaces, then it will not work. If you use tab or space, then it will not work. You have to give br tag only. Then HTML is not case sensitive. Means what? Case sensitive means you can write tag as a capital P or a small p. Its meaning is same. But it is recommended to use lowercase. It is recommended by the W3C that you, when you create your web page, in that you use tag in lowercase only. So we have seen this. HTML is the root tag. In that body, you write whole content, or heading, you use H1 to H6 tags. Then every tag having different attributes. When you use any HTML tag, that every HTML tag having attributes. Attributes means properties. So that are the additional information about these elements. For example, here we have used anchor tag. So in anchor tag, we have used attribute as href. In that, we have given the URL of the web page that you want to open. Then what is the second attribute? Like if you use image tag, img tag. In img tag, you use src attribute to give the path of the image. So in src views, we specify the path of that image that you want to display. Then when you give the path of that image, then that path having two types. First is absolute URL and second is the relative URL. What is the difference between absolute URL and relative URL? So absolute URL, in that you give full path of that image. So that image is present in w3schools.com, in that images folder is there, and in that images folder, that image name is img_girl.jpg. So this is the absolute URL. Then in a relative URL, from your location where your image is present, that path you are giving. Suppose you are in the W3 schools website. So when you want to open that image, then you directly visit to the images folder and you give name of that image, img_girl.jpg. So here that image path is short. So in most of the web pages, relative path is given. Because when we change the server of that web page, then that absolute path may change. So that's why a relative path is used to display that image. Then when you display that image, that we said that attribute width and height of that image. So these are all also attribute. For image, src is attribute, width is attribute, and height is attribute. In src, we give that path of that image, where that image is present. We give width, then we give height of that image. Then alt attribute. What is the use of alt attribute? Yesterday I have told, if by some reason if that image is not displayed, then instead of that image, that text is displayed. So this is the alternate text. In that you can give text, girl with a jacket. So means that image is not displayed, then that text is displayed. Yesterday I have shown that I have changed that image name. That's why that image is not displayed. Then that alternate text is displayed on the web page. So you can click on try it yourself. And here you can see the code and the output. Yes. Suppose if you change the width and height, then that image width and height will be also changed. Then if you change the path, change the name, then that image will not displayed. Then you will get that alternate text, girl with a jacket. So like this, we can use HTML tag, img tag with different attributes like src, alt text, width, then height. Then if we give correct path, then click on run. That image will be displayed. Again, we can give size. Suppose I want width as a 200 and height as a 300 pixel. Then click on run. Then size will be resize of that image. So every time you have to change that code and click on run in W3 School online HTML editor. Then next, style attribute. So using style, you can give different color, font, and size to your web page. So this is the style attribute. In that they have used color as a red, and in this way that red color will be applied for that paragraph. So you can see, click on try it yourself. So HTML online editor will be open. And in that you can see this is a red paragraph output of that. Suppose you want to change that color. Suppose I want color, different color. Then you can give that color name. Then color will be changed. Here I have used blue color for that paragraph. So when blue color is used, then that paragraph will be displayed in the blue color. If you use green color, then that paragraph will be displayed in the green color. So like here, you have to change that color name. If I give orange, then that paragraph will be in orange. Which is your favorite color, according to that you can set. Pink. Violet. Maroon color. So whatever color you want to set, you have to give under attribute style, and you have to give that color in double quote, color colon at color name. So in this way, you can give different color to your text in HTML. Then when you create HTML page, in that there is one attribute as lang. So lang shows that is the what is the language of your web page. Suppose your web page language is English, so in that HTML you use en as a language. Lang is equal to en. So this is also one attribute. So English language having different types. So there is US English, UK English. So like that, you can specify US English. Then when you create your web page, you have to set that title of that element. So you can use title attribute. So here one paragraph is created, and in that title is given, I am a tooltip. And what is the use of this title attribute? So when you took your mouse over that element, then that title will be displayed. So see here, click on try it yourself. And you will get that code. So in that second element, there is p tag in that paragraph is created, in that some text is written. Mouse over this paragraph to display the title attribute to a tooltip. So when I take mouse over this paragraph, I am getting I am a tooltip as a title. So getting all of you? So when you take mouse over this, you will get that title, I am a tooltip. So like this, you can set title of that paragraph. जेव्हा तुम्ही माउस त्यावर न्याल तर तेव्हा तो टायटल डिस्प्ले होईल. नेक्स्ट दे हॅव सजेस्टेड यू यूज लोअर केस ॲट्रिब्यूट्स. वेन वी हॅव क्रिएटेड HTML वेब पेजेस, इन दॅट वी आर युझिंग टॅग्स इन लोअर केस. सेम ॲट्रिब्यूट्स ऑर प्रॉपर्टीज ऑल्सो यू कॅन यूज इन लोअर केस ओनली. If you write title in small or title in capital, this is same, but W3C recommends that you write all the attributes in HTML in lowercase only. Then next, when you write any attribute values in your web page, then use that in double quote. For example, here you can see anchor tag is used, and in that href is used. So that website address is in double quote. Are you getting? So this is good. Any attribute value you give, that you have to give in double quote. So here that double quote is not given. So that is not recommended. So you can see problem if you don't give double quote. So see this example. So here is one paragraph and its title is given. So title, in that they have missed double quote. So they have to give title as about W3 schools. And in that paragraph is created. So when you take your mouse over that paragraph, you are getting title as about only. Yes. जेव्हा मी माउस त्या पॅरेग्राफवरून नेतोय तर तेव्हा फक्त मला अबाउट हे आउटपुट मिळते, पण मला आउटपुट काय पाहिजे? अबाउट W3 स्कूल्स. सो हेअर जी ऍट्रिब्यूटची व्हॅल्यू आहे त्यामध्ये तुम्हाला डबल कोट ऍड करायचं. देन क्लिक ऑन रन. सो नाऊ यू कॅन सी यू आर गेटिंग आउटपुट ॲज अबाउट W3 स्कूल्स. सो डोंट मिस द डबल कोट्स इन द ऍट्रिब्यूट व्हॅल्यू. Otherwise, you will get that partial title. So getting all of you? Also, if you want that paragraph text as bold, then here B tag is used. So if you use that B tag, then your output will be in bold. So you can see here. If you want a normal, then you directly use text in the paragraph tag. But if you want bold, then you use B tag. Then whether we have to use single quote or double quote, so in some situation we have to use single quote and in some situation we have to use double quote. So here in this chapter we have seen different HTML elements and its attribute. We have seen anchor tag, then attributes of anchor tag as href, then we have seen image tag to display image, in that we have seen src attribute, height width attribute of image tag, alternate text attribute of image tag. Also we have seen style attribute. Using that we can change the color, font and size of the text. We have seen lang attribute, in that we can set the language of the web page. Then we have seen title attribute, in that we can set the tooltip of that paragraph. When we take mouse over that paragraph, we are getting the output. Then to test our knowledge, there are some exercises. So can anyone tell, if I want to add tooltip to the paragraph as about W3 schools, then what I have to write here? Which attribute I have to write here? Sangu shakta ka koni? You can unmute and tell. Also you can type in chat. So you can click on start the exercise and you can check your knowledge of HTML. If you think that I know the HTML I have learned in the diploma or in 12th standard. Then you can solve this exercise. You can check your knowledge. So for I want to give tooltip. Then you have to give title as the attribute. Then you can click on submit and you can check that answer. So when you give that correct attribute, click on submit. So you are getting correct. Then next question will be displayed. Here I want to set the size of that image at 250 pixel and 400 pixel tall. Then how you can set? Kasa set karal tumhi width and height? Can anyone
200 take? Pixel width and height 400.
400. Good. Submit. Correct. Next. Now tell.
HREF.
Very good. HREF. Click on submit. Incorrect. Ajun kay add karav lagel? Yes. HREF is incorrect. It is showing. आवाज येत नाहीये चॅट चॅट मध्ये पण टाकू शकता तुम्ही आन्सर चॅट मध्ये पण टाइप करून सेंड करू शकता जर तुमच्याकडे रेंज नसेल तर. Yes. रेल सारंग सांगतोय की REL टॅग यूज करा. नम्रता म्हणते इक्वल टू राहिले. ओके सो वी ऍड इक्वल टू HREF इज इक्वल टू देन ज्यांना आन्सर द्यायचं नसेल त्यांनी झालं की म्यूट करा तुमचा ऑडिओ. साक्षी सो HREF इज इक्वल टू देन क्लिक ऑन. So it is correct. So when you write any attribute, you have to write is equal to. Next. याचं कोण सांगतंय? एक इमेज डिस्प्लेड केली w3schools.png आणि तिथे अल्टरनेट टेक्स्ट डिस्प्ले करायचे. So which tag you can which attribute you can use. Can anyone tell? You can type in chat also. You can unmute and tell also. की कोणता ऍट्रिब्यूट आपण यूज करतो अल्टरनेट टेक्स्ट देण्यासाठी इमेजला. सपोज इमेज जर प्रेझेंट नसेल तर. पूजा पाटील सांगते अल्ट. ओके व्हेरी गुड. अल्ट ALT क्लिक ऑन सबमिट. करेक्ट. सो अल्टरनेट टेक्स्ट देण्यासाठी अल्ट ऍट्रिब्यूट आपण यूज करतो. नेक्स्ट हेडिंग्स ऍड करायच्या एज अ लंडन. Then which tag we can use?
H1.
Okay. Pude.
/H1.
Okay, very good. So click on submit. Correct. H1 madhe apan text dilay. Next. Add 6 headings in the document with the hello. Starting from most important heading to the least important heading. कोणी सांगू शकतो का आंसर व्हाट आंसर आय विल राईट
H1 हॅलो / कंप्लीट त्यानंतर H6 पर्यंत
व्हेरी गुड
हॅलो हा H1 कंप्लीट त्यानंतर H2
नेक्स्ट
H3
next H4 next H5 next H2 very good so click on submit So this is correct. So next exercise, who will tell that answer? ते इथे युनिव्हर्सल स्टुडिओ प्रेझेंटला मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट हेडिंग द्यायचे ज्युरासिक पार्कला पण मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट हेडिंग द्यायचं आहे अबाउटला मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट आणि लास्टला पॅरेग्राफ म्हणून सेट करायचे सो टेल द आन्सर
Universal H1
H1 okay universal H1 okay Jurassic Park
two
Jurassic Park Lash 2 H1 H2 okay next about la
H3
नेक्स्ट पॅरेग्राफ ला
पी टॅग
ओके सो क्लिक ऑन सबमिट सो इट इज करेक्ट देन नेक्स्ट हियर वी हॅव टू डिस्प्ले हॅलो वर्ल्ड in paragraph so can anyone tell
title p sorry paragraph pp
p tag
p tag
Correct. Okay. Now tell this proper end tag.
Backward slash H1.
Close in H1.
Okay, very good. So we have to close slash H1 and slash P. Correct. Next, horizontal line एक draw करायची आहे त्यामध्ये. Horizontal rule between the heading and paragraph. HR. नंबर तो सांगते HR add करा. So HR click on submit. Correct. Next, add a line break in the middle of that paragraph.
BR tag.
BR. Very good. Next, प्री टैग यूज करा. नंबर तो सांगते की प्री टैग यूज करा. सो वी यूज प्री क्लिक ऑन सबमिट. करेक्ट. नेक्स्ट, now tell this so in the this web page we have to set the color as a blue. सगळे आंसर नंबर तर सांगणार का, बाकीचे नाही प्रेझेंट. Style is equal to blue. Pooja, very good. Style is equal to blue. Submit. Incorrect. हाँ वैभव, कोलन ब्लू. इथे तर ऑलरेडी डबल कोड दिलाय ना, आपण कोलन कसं ऍड करू शकतो. कलर, ओके, ब्लूच्या अगोदर कलर आणि इथे कोलन. ओके, आता करेक्ट. यस, नेक्स्ट सांगा. याला फॉन्ट सिलेक्ट सेट करायचं आहे कुरियर. कसा सेट करणार फॉन्ट, कॅन एनीवन टेल? गेस करू शकता तुम्ही काय असेल? सपोज आय यूज हेअर फॉन्ट. इनकरेक्ट. कॅन एनीवन गेस? फॉन्ट. No. Can anyone help me? Font family. Varsha sangte ki font family use kar. Font colon family. Okay. Font dash family. Okay. Font dash family. Yes. Attribute the font name, font dash family. Next. Yala center alignment tumhala use karayche. काय करावं लागेल? स्टाईल मध्ये अलाइनमेंट सेंटर करायचे. टेक्स्ट डॅश अलाइन. ओके. टेक्स्ट डॅश अलाइन. ओके करेक्ट. नेक्स्ट टेक्स्ट साइज 50 पिक्सल सेट करायचे. सो हाऊ वी कॅन सेट टेक्स्ट साइज एज 50 पिक्सल? कॅन एनीवन टेल? फॉन्ट डॅश साईज. वैष्णवी सांगते फॉन्ट डॅश साईज. ओके.
फॉन्ट डॅश साईज बोलून.
ओके. नेक्स्ट इथे बॅकग्राऊंड कलर येलो द्यायचा आहे बॉडीला. सो हाऊ वी कॅन सेट बॅकग्राऊंड कलर एज येलो? कसा देता येईल बॅकग्राऊंड कलर एज येलो? Can anyone tell background color? Background dash color. Okay. Yes. So you can use background dash color. Next तर यामध्ये पूर्ण बॉडी मधलं कंटेंट ला सेंटर अलाइन यूज करायची. सगळं एच वन आणि पी सेंटर मध्ये डिस्प्ले झालं पाहिजे. देन हाऊ वी कॅन डू सेंटर अलाइनमेंट? style text dash align colon center. Okay. Yes. Next, we have to give extra importance to the degradation. कस करता येईल डिग्रेडेशन एक्स्ट्रा इम्पॉर्टन्स झाला पाहिजे त्यात. स्ट्रॉंग सो यू कॅन यूज स्ट्रॉंग टॅग. Working. Next, emphasize the word metropolitan. We have to give emphasize to that word metropolitan. Which tag I can use? Can anyone tell? EM. EM for emphasis. Next, highlight the fun word. So how we can highlight? Strong tag name. Strong is correct. No, strong is not correct. Mark. So mark, using that you can highlight. Next, subscript. आपल्याला माहिती आहे H2O चा फॉर्म्युला, त्यामध्ये H2 आपण खाली बॉटमला लिहितो. सबस्क्रिप्ट यूज करायचं त्या टू साठी. तो कसं यूज करणार? कोणता टॅग आहे? सब. नेक्स्ट, त्या टेक्स्ट वर स्ट्राईक आउट झालं पाहिजे. ब्लू या टेक्स्ट वर डॅश आला पाहिजे मध्ये. कसं करणार? कोणता टॅग आहे स्ट्राईक करण्यासाठी? कॅन एनीवन टेल? डिलीट टॅग. डेल. नेक्स्ट, कोटेशन मार्क करायचंय कूल या लेटर बरोबर. सो हाऊ वी कॅन मार्क द कोटेशन? येस, कि तो कूल हा वर्ड आहे तो कोट मध्ये आला पाहिजे. Can anyone tell? Q. So today we stop here. So like this, you can solve this exercise and you will get different tags. So write your roll numbers and names in chat for attendance.